Right, class, settle down, settle down. It's time for me to give you some information about the trip we're going to have tomorrow. So you need a bit of background information as to where we're going, where we are going. So here it is. This is a whole story, so much too long to tell, but I will tell you the main parts. As you know, the meerkats and mongooses aren't friends. In fact, they're enemies. But over the last few years, it has only got worse. Everything happens at one has to be beaten by the other. Both sides want the ultimate victory. Now, there are plans, as we understand it, for the mongoose overlord to launch an attack here on Stag Root. We have no final proof, but there are several sources. So with the proof we have given, the meerkat troops have been armed and told to be on standby any day, any time of day or night. Although there is one chance of hope, Mr. Edvard Olofsky, tomorrow he sets off for that clump, City of the Mongoose. When he arrives, no one knows what may be waiting for him. We can only hope he manages in his mission. We are going to port to watch the ship's send-off party. See you tomorrow. Don't forget to take a permission slip as you each go. Bye, see you tomorrow.
Bye.
See you later.
God help Edvard. God help us.
People of Stag Root, thank you for being with me today to celebrate our future hero. Edvard means so much to us all. I wanted him to know that he will be in all of our hearts. Without Edvard, we would have no hope. We will all probably end up dying. But thanks to Edvard, the hope has been restored. Him and the rest of his crew are such a brave bunch. Going somewhere so bad, most of us can't even imagine where they are going. I would never be able to get there. So I present to you, Edvard Olofsky.
I really am not worth all this, guys. Thanks. Right, let me explain. For years I've wanted to give something back to this place that has brought me so much hope, so much love, and so much joy. So thank you all for believing in me, and even more importantly, trusting me. So here I go, leaving in the name of our great town, our great mayor, and our great royal family. Without you guys and your hope, I would not be doing what I am about to do today. So thank you for being here, all of you. Thanks. I will pass back over to the great mayor as I board the ship. The vessel at the head of all of your minds. Without this girl, we would have to... Gentlemen, thanks for being with me at such short notice. I've just had news that Edvard has been launched into the sea. His reception was good.
But doesn't he have, no hope, man? He's, dead in 5 minutes. He isn't us, is he? What does he think he is? Something special? We're the only ones that stand any chance.
Pongo, strictly professional, please!
Okay, chillax, dude. Okay, sir.
Right, don't worry, there are more pressing problems at hand. Manga? What are our chances? What is Edvard's chances?
Well, Mr. Gockett, sir, Edvard has a strong crew and a good brain about him. If he manages to get to the Mongoose City soon, he does stand a slight chance. If we were to send him back up, it almost doubles our chances.
Shall we send them in, then? I mean the troops. Surely if it gives us a chance of winning this battle, it has to be worth it.
But the mayor has issued a lockdown to us, sir. He doesn't want Edvard bothered. I'm guessing this is mainly because he'll do nothing for the hope the people have. They'll realise his chances, but also because home security is our best chance. Defending our territory gives us the best chance of winning this war. If we can protect the people, bring the moral right up, and gather volunteers for the army. With our soldiers, the people, and our armoury department, it almost quadruples our chances. I shouldn't say this, but it is part of my job. We do have the resources to overrule the mayor and go against his will. Just say the word. Either way, you have to make a decision now.
Okay, thanks, Manga. Send out the
I don't think so.
Mr. Mayor, sir, we can't risk this. We need our army out there. We need to have control of this battle. It's the only way. But by order of your country and world, tell me, Mango, is there another way?
Yes, sir. Staying in the current battle plan, we stand the best chance, sir.
Thank you. I know that can't have been easy for you. Now, that is what we shall do. Oh, and while the war is going on, your power to choose the right decision has been withdrawn. But, sir, you can't do that. Only your founder has the permission? Yes, I know. I've spoken to him, and I have a written agreement with his consent for this action to happen. Do you need me to show you? No, sir. We shall do as you say, straight away. Thanks, Grogol. I know I could count on you and your men. Make the necessary arrangements. We are staying right here and defending our turf.
Yes, sir.
That is decided, then. We are staying right here. Position meerkats around the whole perimeter. I want them all with the best weapons available to anything. We are going to win the war. But to do that, we are going to need to use any spare meerkats we have to go out with the people. Go to social events, community centres, school fetes. Convince the people they are safe. That it will be much more effective for them to come and help us win the war. The men will be transported tonight, midnight, when no one should be around. If anyone is, the alibi is training. Right, set the necessary arrangements. Pongo, you are ahead of getting the troops where they need to be, in position. Manga, when you have finished setting the necessary arrangements for Pongo, get the people out there.
Yes, sir. Okay, dude. Sir.
Sergei, we have been at sea for one day now. Do you have anything to report?
We are making good progress. We should hit Mongol spots in a few days. It's possible to be there tomorrow, but it all depends on weather.
Thanks for the update. Any news from home? No doubt they will have sent someone after me by now, right?
Oh no, sir. They've been denied access. HQ tried to send reinforcements, but the mayor went to General Dimitri and he began the whole HQ organization, making him the only person capable of stopping any procedures that HQ allow. The mayor's explained that the chances are the city will be better protected if they defend the area. Dimitri has agreed to withdraw decision-making from the HQ for the time being. Power is back to the government are acting on your behalf and doing a great job of it.
Now, that's good news, but get back to the captain. Tell him I want full power. Do everything possible to get us there by as early as possible, preferably tomorrow. Give me as much time as possible to prepare the necessary arrangements.
Thanks, sir. I'll handle that, sir.
Ah, Ricky, Sam, so glad to see you. Good day, I suppose so. I mean, you have the greatest job in the world. Every kid's dream, you're an agent for crying out loud. Anyway! What news do you have for me?
Yes, we have lots of news and great jobs too, sir. We spotted on the software back at HQ there's a ship on its way in towards us. It's about half a day away, and by the looks and the direction it's come from, we're predicting it's from the meerkats. It can't be good. We've run a full check on the ship from HQ, and as far as we can tell, it's an attacking vessel. It's the newest equipment on board. Unfortunately, it's even more advanced than our own.
How many people on board? The heat sensors reckon at least 10, maybe more. We can't predict exactly, because we don't have the technology they have. They have done well to manage to get this far undetected. They're a big threat to us. What do you want us to do about the situation? As far as I'm concerned, we have no one choice and one choice only. This is to stop them at all costs, even if it means sending our own troops in. I know it's a waste of money and troops, but it stops them getting to us. It's the only choice we have, right? Unless you have anything else.
That is what I was planning to do. I just think the risk is so high to be worth it. Think of it this way. If we lose all our troops to these people, we could well do, because we don't know how this new technology works, it could wipe out one person or a whole lot of troops. It could be more effective to keep hold of them, welcome them, play them to our strengths, make them think that they have us wrapped around their fingers. We do everything they ask, within reason. We accommodate them, make them feel it's just the government we want that wants this fight to continue.
So you're going to blame me? What is this, sacrifice one, save the rest? Because that's what it sounds like. If this is your plan, forget it. I am not playing along. No problem. That's what we're going to do. If we make them think that you are responsible, the rest of us don't want to be part of this, but I mean the whole situation, they can take it as they wish. But they will never know whether to trust us or not. So to prove how we should trustworthy we are to them, we'll tie you up and take you to them. Then in a situation we have already got planned out, we prove our loyalty to the Meerkat crew. How? Well, simple. We just burn you at the stake. That was my Meerkat impression. Burn me at the stake? What are you thinking of? That will never work. Not even in a million years. Kill me? You said you wouldn't.
But we won't, Meelin, sir. We won't. We have it all planned out to work in such a way that we can get you out of there as the burning takes place. We're going to put a smoke gas bomb in the fire. And when it gets touched by the flames, it breaks, allowing a smog out. It looks like a normal fire, but no one will be able to see you. With a few fake screams and cries, we could easily get you away. Understand?
Excellent. And then what? We have the scientists in place. When they arrive, we're going to get them on the ship, or close enough to be able to use our technology to investigate theirs. Then as we burn you, the scientists predict it is going to take them 2 hours to get the information they need. It happens that we decide how long the ceremony is going to be. It's about 2 hours. When they have a chance to beat the Meerkats, it's game over for them. Am I right in saying we should arrive within the next few hours?
According to the captain, we could make it there in an hour, yeah, putting all the men into getting us there quickly, under your orders from yesterday. But I have to reverse my opinion to you. I don't think it's the best possible decision.
Why ever not? We need to get there. Time is running out. Do we have another choice?
Well, my personal opinion is that if we are using all our power to get in, that's fine. But using our men, overworking them, could cause them not to be as...